What's going on, guys? It's your boy Adjen Bagen for another Epic 7 video. Yes, you heard me right, guys. An Epic 7 video. I returned to Epic 7 a few days ago, which I'm here to share with you my experience as a returning player to Epic 7. Is it a really good time to return to Epic 7? Or is it a really good time to start Epic 7 for players who have not played Epic 7 in 2024? I think it's always a good time to start and play Epic 7 because Epic 7 is a wonderful game. There are a lot of contents to do, especially if you're a beginner or a returning player. That is one of the benefits of playing Epic 7 because loads and loads of contents are waiting for you to be able to play the game. And it will take you hundreds of hours maybe, or even hundreds of hours farming just to get really good, decent characters in this game. But the ride for playing this game is always a fun thing. Now, why am I on and off in this game? Let's be real here, guys, because burnout is inevitable in any gacha game out there, or in every gacha game out there. You will always come to a point where you get burnt out, and that happens to me. But usually I get burnt out on games like this one because there are no really good QOLs that can help me feel satisfied playing the game. But right now we have some really nice QOLs added into the game, and I think it's really worth playing Epic 7 right now. Especially right now, Epic 7 is having a collaboration with Overlord, one of my favorite animes manga out there, which is really, really nice. And you get to have a pre-Moonlight 5-star character, which is Ainz Ul Gold. I'm not sure if he is a really good character. I just use him for the event that we have right now. Ainz Ul Gold is a mage. Yeah, this is my Ainz. It's already S imprint here. I've been farming the event, which is I'm gonna be making a separate video talking about the Overlord collaboration event. But I think it's really a good time to start Epic 7 again, especially if you are a returning player. There are lots of benefits from being a returning player. What are those benefits? So let me show you the benefits of those one. If you take a look at the special rewards for returning heirs, it's really darn good. I've already experienced this a lot of times since I am on and off to the game. And the rewards for as a returning player is not a joke. It's really good. If you will see here the login returning user check-in event, as you can see, we have a 14 days check-in event. At day 7, you will be able to get a 5-star artifact here. At the second week, you will be able to get a 5-star random 5-star character. And then you get some free gold transmit stones. This is considering 2 ml summons right here. And then the good thing about this one, you get this one, this battle here. This one can ascension your character to 6-star already. And then this one, awaken your character to 6-star, fully awaken without spending any materials, which is really, really bonkers. It gives you Molagora for upgrading your skills. It gives you Leaps for stamina refresh. And then daily you will be getting stamina here and upgrade the sigils to upgrade your gears. And then the good part is the set. You get a level 88 speed set and a level 88 counter set. Complete set. From weapon to accessories, yada yada. All 6 parts complete with this one. Which, in my honest opinion, the best part of a returning player, the best thing to look forward as a returning player. Not only that one, you will be able to get a pre-summons on the standard banner, which can get you some really good 5-star, even an ML 5-star if you are very lucky with your summons. Really, really nice. The level 88 equipment set are all legendary, which in my honest opinion, really darn good. I will show you my gears that I gotten from that one. That one, those gears are really, really awesome. The speed set, Looks something like this. The one that I showed you with my eyes, like this one. This one has a really nice substats also. Attack speed, critical chance, even though there is some effectiveness here. The helmet is also really good. Especially if you roll, even though the armor is not that good. Some pieces are really darn good. That is why it's really worth coming back to Epic 7 as a returning player. Not only that one, not only the returning players that check and reward, you will get lots of buffs. As you can see here, this one, not this one, this one is from the regular one. We have the pre-unequip event, this one, and then the welcome blessings. As you can see, for 30 days, you will be able to gain battle experience 30%, battle gold earned 30%, and then 100% conquest points from arena attacks. More arena tokens by having this one. Can enter spirit altars of all enemies, and then minus 100% cost for unequipping all equipment. So this one is also something like a pre-unequip event, which is really, really good. Aside from the check-in reward for a returning player, and aside from the buffs that you will be getting once you get back into the game, there is also a milestone event where you can get really nice stuff. As you can see, we have here the greeting event, the welcome back event here. If you just do your thing for 3 days, you will be able that will gain lots of stuff. I've already completed this one, so I cannot show you the rewards, but this one, the third day, I just need to do one mystic summon and then I will be able to complete this one. I've gotten golds, bookmarks, really nice stuff just by doing the welcome back event. This one, you will be doing this one really, really easily, since you're going to be farming the game, playing the game. You will earn lots and lots of freebies just by playing the game. So it's really worth coming back to Epic 7. Also, if you have not played Epic 7, I think it's also a really good time to play Epic 7, since we have a lot of really good rewards, especially from the what do you call this, from the Overlord collaboration event. So we have here in the Epic 7 Overlord collaboration tab here, you can get really nice gear here. As you can see here in the Overlord's Force, you can get this necklace. This necklace is a level 88, a really top tier necklace here, with some really good substats. Attack, speed, and then critical chance substats are all really, really good, except for defense. But there are defense scaling characters in this game, so it's not really that bad to get rolls on defense. That is why this necklace is one thing to aim for, especially if you've returned to the game. So this one is really, really good. Aside from that one, we have really nice gacha gears here, like this one. This one might be level 78 only, but still it will help you in progressing your account through the game. Lots and lots of stuff here. You can get some bookmarks also here to summon. Really darn good. So yeah, just take note that I'm not paid to advertise the game, just to be clear. But I'm really enjoying my time playing with Epic 7 again. I do have the free time to play Epic 7 because in my other gacha games, there's really nothing much else to do. That is why I decided to return to Epic 7, and I'm having a blast returning to Epic 7. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And I think that's it for me for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe. I would really appreciate it if you could help me grow my channel more. And thank you to everyone who are supporting my channel. I appreciate every one of you. Until next time, peace.